want to solve the given exponential equations using the properties of exponents. And in these examples, we can write the left side of the right side of the equation using the same base, therefore we can solve these equations without logarithms. In general, if we have a to the power of m equal to a to the power of n, then m is equal to n. This is telling us that if we have two exponential expressions that are equal to each other, and the bases are the same, then the exponents must be equal. So looking at our first example, notice how our bases are not the same because this base is 3 and this base is 9. But since 9 is equal to 3 times 3 or 3 squared, we can rewrite this as 3 to the power of 2x plus 5 equals 3 squared to the power of 3x minus 7. Now notice we do have a common base of 3, but on the right side we have 3 squared raised to the power of 3x minus 7, or we have a power raised to a power, which means we can multiply these exponents given by this rule here. So we can rewrite this as 3 to the power of 2x plus 5 equals 3 raised to the power of 2 times the quantity 3x minus 7. And in this form, now that the bases are the same and these are equal to each other, 2x plus 5 must equal 2 times the quantity 3x minus 7. Now we can solve this equation for x to determine our solution. So we'll start by clearing the parentheses here. So we'll have 2x plus 5 equals, this will be 6x minus 14. We need to get x on one side of the equation, so let's go ahead and subtract 2x on both sides of the equation. Notice how this would make the x terms on the right side of the equation, since this would be 0. So let's go ahead and add 14 here at the same time. So on the left side we have 5 plus 14, that's 19. On the right side we have 6x minus 2x, that's 4x. And this is 0 as well. So now we'll divide both sides by 4. We have 19 fourths equals x, which is our solution, or we can write x equals 19 fourths by switching the order. Looking at our second example, we do have this fraction here to deal with, but we know 4 is equal to 2 squared, so we could write this as 1 over 2 squared raised to the 2x plus 1 power. And then on the right side, 64 can also be written as 2 raised to a power. 64 is equal to 8 times 8, and 8 is equal to 4 times 2, and 4 is equal to 2 times 2. So each 8 contains 3 factors of 2. So 64 is equal to 6 factors of 2, or 2 to the 6th. Now we could have actually left this as base 4 because 64 is also equal to 4 to the 3rd, but if we're ever in doubt, we can always break things down into their prime factors. Now again, we still have this fraction to deal with. We want to have a common base of 2 on both sides of the equation. So now what we can do is move 2 to the 2nd up into the numerator and rewrite this as 2 to the power of negative 2. Again, remember, if we cross a fraction bar, it's going to change the sign of the exponent. So we'd have 2 raised to the power of negative 2 raised to the power of 2x plus 1 equals 2 to the 6th. And again, on the left side now, we have powers raised to powers, so we're going to multiply these exponents. So we'll have 2 raised to the power of negative 2 times the quantity 2x plus 1 equals 2 to the 6th. Now that we have these equal to each other and the bases are the same, the exponents must be equal. So negative 2 times the quantity 2x plus 1 must equal 6. So now we'll clear the parentheses. So we'll have negative 4x minus 2 equals 6. So we'll add 2 to both sides of the equation. This will be 0, so we have negative 4x equals 8. Divide both sides by negative 4. We have x equals negative 2. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.